Okay, I wanted to add a little bit more to that video on the 240 volt ground fault. And the one thing I didn't think about and got reminded by K456, and he let me know, and thanks to him, what does the white wire do? I mentioned it, and I said it went through the inductor here, but I didn't really mention why it's there. Well, there's three terminals here, and of course, that one terminal in the center is a neutral, and it goes through the inductor, but on some 240 volt appliances, there is a part of the circuit is 120 volts. Now, if let's say I had an electric dryer, and I would have 240 volts going between these two for the element, but the controls, the timers and so on like that, maybe 120 volts. So what they're going to have is one lead power going through, and then it comes back through this neutral here. Well, what these have, this neutral wire here goes to the neutral lugs on the main panel. And the reason this is all done is that if I took, let's say I had my 10 amps I talked about before, or 10 amps here, 10 amps here, running through the element, but then I had 1 amp going through the controls, then I would have an unbalanced circuit here. And the ground fault would kick off. So what they do is you run the neutral back through the inductor and out this wire to the neutral lugs, and that balances the circuit again. It cancels out the 1 amp that was going here and coming back, because it goes through the inductor, it just cancels it out. I didn't explain that. I probably didn't even really think about it when I was doing it before. So I just wanted to put that in, so maybe a little better understanding of how these things work. Well, I guess that's it on that one.